Ox 55 Sports. This is the Locker Room.
We're excited to play him, and we're glad we get to play him at home. You know, it's great for us to see how we match up against a really solid ACAC team, and, you know, obviously a team that beat us 2 years ago in the sectional final. And so I think it'll be a great high school football game, great atmosphere, small school football, small town feel. I think it's really what the playoffs are supposed to be about.
I was excited. Everybody been talking about them, like how they're good and stuff. I just wanted to get a chance to play them.
Yeah, our sectionals filled with talent and really good teams, so if we can get the confidence and if we went out in the sectional, then we have a pretty good chance of making it pretty far. So I like the odds of just us being able to play in the sectional.
Buska's good. They're really good, but I think they're beatable. I think that our sectional is pretty difficult. As long as we can get through Busco, just step at a time, we should be fine.
It's pretty exciting. Winner go home. It's a big game, but if we just play our game, I think we'll be good.
We'd have to probably beat 4-2 and 3 in the state to win the sectional. But we're trying to sell it as, hey, embrace that. It's fun to play in games like this, get the game of the week on a couple stations, things like that. So it's fun to be a part of that. And you're there because you've taken care of business as far as the season goes with 7 wins. So we're excited. Embrace the atmosphere and have fun playing football on Friday night.
So a top 10 throwdown in Turtletown. What a way to start the postseason. Welcome in, everybody, alongside my partner, Peter Hood. My name, Justin Prince. This is The Locker Room. Thanks for being with us tonight. Pete, it's about that time, man. Win or clean out your lockers.
Yep.
For everyone across the state.
Yeah, you mentioned it on last night's sportscast. One of the benefits of the blind draw, we get to see some pretty good matchups right off the bat. Just like this one, for example. They're fired up at Churubusco. 1A number 4 Eagles playing host to 6th-ranked South Adams. Pick this one up in the 4th. Starfires down a touchdown, but they're driving. James Arnold extending the play allows Drew Stutzman to get open across the middle. He dodges a couple tacklers into Busco territory, finally pushed out of bounds. Later in the drive, it's Arnold to Stutzman again, and this one counts for 6. South Adams ties the game at 21 apiece after the extra point. Ensuing Busco drive, Nathaniel Keener, you won't find a man with a mullet that's meaner, has a crease for a big first down run. They get it all the way down to the 1-yard line. This time they fake it to Keener, and it's Tom Richards in for the game-winning score. Party at Tommy Football's house tonight, folks. Busco wins the battle of the top 10 teams, 28-21, your final in the game of the week.
So Busco advances to play the winner between Adams Central and Northfield late second quarter. Jets with the lead. Logan Macklin takes the pitch outside, turns upfield, gets first down yardage. He's really good, Pete.
Yeah, you said it.
Later in the drive, this one's just impressive. Macklin takes the pitch, goes to his right, doesn't like what he sees, reverses fields.
It's like a video game.
He's going to take it to the house. Mm. That's 6. Adams Central takes the 27-10 lead at recess. Northfield makes things interesting, but the Jets hang on to win 34-23, your final.
More sectional 43 action. Southwood taking on Eastside down in Wabash tonight. Pick it up in the first quarter. No score. Knights knocking on the door. Alex Farr tries to keep it around the left side himself, but the Blazers deny him at the 1, and Eastside takes over on downs, but the Knights just too good. They'd eventually find their way to the end zone, and often Gabe Lloyd takes the handoff up the middle, carries a few guys with him all the way down to the 5, and then a few plays later, Farr calls his own number, punches it in from a yard out. Southwood takes the 7-0 lead. They roll to a 44-6 win.
So they get the winner of this game between Fremont and Southern Wells. Fremont,
okay,
what a win for them. 25-14 over Southern Wells.
Move up to Class 2A. Central Noble hosting Wabash to open things up in sectional 34. Both teams struggled to move the ball offensively for much of the first quarter, and then late in the period, Wabash offense, it busts through. Jared Holly got places to be and people to see. He's out 64 yards to the crib. Apaches take the early lead, but on the ensuing kickoff, you're going to see a good return here from Noah Christopher. Guy's got two first names, and he's tough to tackle. Carrying tacklers across midfield into Wabash territory, Central Noble drives all the way down to the one-foot line. Fourth down, trying to tie the game early in the second, but the Wabash defense holds. Huge stop to force the turnover on downs. Central Noble, though, they would eventually break through. The Cougars come back to win it 30-22, the final up in Albion tonight.
So the Cougs move on to play the winner between Woodland and Bremen. Woodland, runner-up at state last year in 2A. Bremen leading 14-7 here in the second quarter. Ryan Caldwell, he's going to be on the read option, fools everyone, and he runs it in himself for the touchdown. Bremen goes up by two scores. Later on in the quarter, Caldwell looking to throw, fires a rocket over the middle for Justin Zumbrin. That's six more. Bremen wins it 35-27, ending the Woodland season early.
Unfortunate. Staying in 2A, Bluffton beats Manchester tonight 35-0. Tigers roll. And how about Prairie Heights? They get a sectional win over Whitco 28-22, the final there.
To Class 3A we go. Sectional 28, West Noble in Ossian taking on Norwell to open playoff action. First quarter, first drive of the game for the Chargers. Third and long, Kyle Mayhorder hits Nick Moore downfield for the first down. And then later on in the drive, another third down for the Chargers. Brandon Pruitt this time takes the handoff, lowers his head, plows his way down inside the 20. That's another first down. And a few plays later, first and goal from the one. Pruitt going to finish the drive with the touchdown. Caps a near six-minute drive to open the game. Knights go up six. Next drive for Norwell, Eli Riley hits Levi Leidig in the flat. He powers his way upfield for the first down. Knights are driving, but things would not go Norwell's way tonight. Riley picked off by Josh Gross to end that drive. West Noble, they go on to win 28-21, your final from Ossian.
All right, so the Chargers, they move on to play the winner between these two teams, Heritage and Bishop Lures, and this one all Lures tonight. 41-0 in the second quarter. Heritage threatening the handoff. Is this dude's name really Lucas Cash Dollar?
Yes.
Knights force the big man to fumble on the one. Josh Dippold recovers. Ensuing drive, Knights marching. Jay McJohnson takes the little shovel pass. He gets upfield inside Patriot territory. But the drive would stall. Lures would punt. Next drive for Heritage. Third and long. Walter Kanapke trying to make something happen. Great effort from the tough lefty here. Gets down close to the first down marker. But he's short. And the Knights take over. Very next play, Jordan Presley takes the handoff up the middle. And you know what Jordan Presley does when he takes the handoff up the middle. 70 yards to the residents. Lures led 55-0 at half. They roll to the 63-24 win.
Ooh. More sectional 28 action for you. Concordia topping Lakeland 28-13. Belmont winners by 10 over Garrett 16-6.
In sectional 27, Tippecanoe Valley, tough loss for them last week against Southwood. They bounce back tonight 34-7, the final against Peru. Fairfield, their season is over with a 42-7 loss at the hands of Mishawaka.
Over to Weicker Stadium, sectional 20 matchup between SAC foes Wayne and Southside. Second quarter, Generals leading 20-0. From the Southside 20, Devin Eric Kelsaw takes the handoff, gets to the outside, off to the races, but he's pushed out at the one. I think that's used for track. He wants to stay out of that.
Yep.
Very next play, got to let him finish. Kelsaw punches it in.
You know the rules.
From 1 yard out. Yeah, get up and throw up that five, young fella.
The nickel.
Generals go up 26 after the failed two-point conversion. Next archer drive, just trying to get anything going.
A lot of white
jerseys
there. Omar
Jackson.
Yeah.
That's not what you want. Taken down for the sack by Xavier Ellington. Archers would punt next general drive, trying to get another score before half. Brandon Young drops back to pass, lofts a deep ball over the middle. Just out of his receiver's reach, Everett Merritt makes the pick. We head to half. Generals up 26-0. They go on to win 50-12. Your final.
So the Generals move on to play the winner of this game, an NEA rematch between Columbia City and New Haven. Bulldogs led 14-7 at the half. They got the ball first to begin the third, but they quickly give it away. Nick Sexton puts it on the ground. Landon Markins is there to recover it for Columbia City. Eagles have the ball in great field position, but the New Haven defense doesn't care. On fourth down, Greg Bolt looking for a receiver. Instead, he gets a face full of James Adams. Sack forces the turnover on downs, and here come the Bulldogs. Tim Jordan hits Steven Owens first down, and you can tack on 15 more for a horse collar tackle. Very next play, Jordan rolling to his right, throwing end zone, and look who comes up with it. Sexton redeems himself on the touchdown. And New Haven, shout out to Caleb Saylor, shout out to Zach Doms. They get some revenge to keep their season alive. 24-14, the final.
Some sectional 20 scores for you tonight. Leo topping Jay County 35-21. And Angola, they top Culver Academy's 27-7 to advance there. To sectional 19 we go. East Noble traveling to DeKalb tonight in the first quarter. Knights up 7, DeKalb headed downfield. Barons running back Tanner Jack breaks off a small chunk of yards to pick up the first down. DeKalb kept plugging away, eventually made it to East Noble's 5-yard line. Senior John Bell punches it in to square things up. Yeah, the Barons supporters, they're pretty happy about that one. East Noble, they're going to be heading the other way here shortly. There they are.
There they are.
East Noble heading the other way shortly. The best night to be throwing the ball. Knights QB throws to Hayden Jones, but the ball's too slick to hold on to. Wouldn't matter. Same drive. Hayden Harshberger avoids a few tackles.
Just give it to that guy.
He's pretty good.
Yep.
Breaks off 55 yards to put the Knights up 14-7. It was a tight battle all night, but East Noble ends the Cavs season 33-32. Your final.
All right, in sectional 19 action, Northwood, they beat Plymouth 40-7. Northwood ranked number one in Class 4A. Northridge 33, Wawasee 12. We'll have more scores from 4A in just a moment. To Class 5A we go right now, though. Windy, rainy night at Rice Field. Northside traveling to take on Elkhart Central. First quarter, no score. Blazers going to the air. Isaiah Chandler throws it up, and Kyron Pearson brings it down. Hits him in stride, 75 yards for the score. Central goes up 7. Later, it's Chandler calling his own number straight up the middle. 19 yards for the TD. Blazers up 14. Northside would finally get some life in the second. Ronald Collins, the third, keeps it himself. Bright future for that young man. He punches it in from 12 yards out. They pull within 8, but Elkhart rolls to the 46-14 win.
And finally, our play of the night takes us back to Turtletown. Tommy Richards rumbling, bumbling, stumbling into the end zone for the game-winning touchdown. Bosco down South Adams, 28-21. Eagles move on to play number 2, Adams Central, in a battle of top 5 teams down in Monroe next Friday. So, Pete, could we be looking at an early possible game of the week for next week?
Potentially. By the way, we didn't forget about Bishop Dwenger or Angola. Bishop Dwenger wins tonight 42-14 over Logansport in sectional 19, so they move on to play Leo next week.
They'll be home next week for that one.
Yeah, too. And Angola, they win tonight 27-7 over Culver. That's a good win for them, and I believe they'll be Northridge next week, if I'm correct there.
I believe so.
Saying that off the top of my head. Check the internet. It's all there.
Promise.
Yeah.
That's going to do it for the high school football for the night. Congrats to all the teams advancing. Don't go.